Hello, and welcome back! We are playing some Valkyrie Chronicles once again. And, well, I forgot to talk about what I kind of experienced during the last few cutscenes of last episode before I ended it off. So, with it, yeah, I was watching the cutscene and then just ended it off, as you probably have seen and watched already. So, last few cutscenes was them getting away from the town, we blowing up a tank. So, right now, the next one here is called Summons. So, I guess we're going to the capital and then getting somehow placed into the military. So, let's see how that all plays out here right now.
In March of 1935, the Empire began its invasion across Gallia's eastern border. Maximilian, commander of the Gallian invasion front, built his army around mobile armor. Ghirlandio and the other fortresses along the border fell to his tanks in quick succession. Bruel's fall in under 2 hours was typical of villages in the Empire's path, and the road to the capital bore a steady flow of refugees. Randgreese, Gallia's capital, a town secure and stable since ancient times. Within its walls stood the castle Randgreese, and within its unicorn spire resided Cordelia, Gallia's princess. Supporting Gallia's policy of neutrality was a system of universal conscription. Under it, all schools required military training each year. In the event of a war, citizens were then drafted into the militia to defend their country. As the conflict with the East grew worse, both Welkin and Alicia found themselves no exceptions to that fate.
These are my new digs. Oh, my uniform. I should get changed before reporting in. Better get ready now.
Well, it looks like we get a new uniform, and like I said, we are getting into the military.
Everything you need for a nice hike or combat.
Welkin? Can I come in?
Sure, it's open.
Oh, you're already changed too. Let's see. Not bad, not bad. You look good, actually. How about me? Do I look all right in this? Convincing?
Let's take a look. Yeah, you look fine. You wear it like a pro.
Really? You're not just saying that?
Of course not. You look tough. I like it.
Oh, good. I was worried it looked kind of silly.
No way! That plating on the back? It's like a coleopterid exoskeleton. Beetle-tastic.
Colio, what? And did you just say beetle? Welkin? What kind of girl wants to hear that she looks like a bug?
Huh? Not just any bug, a rhinoceros beetle, king of the insects. Who wouldn't want that?
Uh-huh. I guess I'll just try to take that as a very welcome sort of compliment.
Tell me about that scarf. You've been wearing it since I met you.
Oh, this? It's part of my uniform from the bakery.
Is that right?
I don't want to forget the time I spent busting my buns baking. I plan to keep wearing it until I can get back to manning the ovens again.
That's great. Once you do, I'll be first in line to get some of that bread.
Is that a promise? Well, I'll be sure to have plenty of it ready and waiting for you.
Absolutely. Hey, if you're ready, we should probably go see the captain now.
It'd be just nice if it, like, jumped us right into the next cutscene, but I guess it's kind of nice that it can leave us off here like this. Just in case it's, like, future episodes where I then just cut them off there and kind of thing, but right now let's keep on going, seeing who this captain is.
Excuse me, ma'am. Galleon Militia enlistee Welkin Gunther, reporting for duty.
Ma'am, Galleon Militia enlistee Alicia Malkiot, also reporting for duty.
I'm Captain Eleanor Varrott, commander of this regiment. Gunther, you're promoted to lieutenant. You'll be leader of Squad 7 now.
Ma'am.
Enlistee Malkiot, you're promoted to sergeant. You'll be under the lieutenant's command. Understood?
Ma'am.
What do you know? It is you. Nice coincidence, huh, Welkin?
Followed you? I had no idea that you'd enlisted.
Yep. Now that there's a real war going on, I joined up. Pretty much all the officer and training boys are here just like you.
You know each other?
Yes, ma'am. We knew each other at university. Welkin was in science and I was in archaeology. And just look at us now. No archaeology or science. Looks like the two of us are studying war, I guess.
Looks that way. It's good to see you.
And you.
That'll be all for now. There's a strategy briefing later today. But you still have time. Time for you to catch up. You'll be spending a lot of time on the post and in Randgreaves. They'll be your new home, so get to know them. That'll be all. Report back in time for the briefing. Until then, you're dismissed.
Alright, well, it looks like we got a new, kind of interface here. So, don't need to go to book mode. Check our equipment and stuff there, now that we have things available to us. So, we got Welkin as a tank commander, and then Alicia is a scout. We got shock trooper now, and then also a lancer. Okay. So we'll have to figure those things out later on. Right now, like those classes later on. But let's see. So we got a few traits here. So being around nature makes his heart soar. Bringing about a boost in his abilities. Okay. Even surrounded by foes, he remains calmly in commander, enjoys a boost of his parliaments. And then we got other things here, which don't seem to be in effect. So then we also got likes at the bottom, clothing, and then other. So we got attachment here. We don't have any other attachments. I can't scroll down either, up or down. So it looks like we can't quite do anything here. Can't edit anything there. Just more things, more traits here. So standing on bare dirt leads to a boost in concentration raising accuracy, okay. And then when any of her close friends are nearby, the desire to protect them drives all of her abilities up, alright. So those are a few things. So it doesn't look like we can do anything here besides check out a few of the things. And like, so let's just go back, see if we can edit anything else and use our XP or something like that. We got training field, so that might be where we can expand our XP. Hopefully.
Welcome to your worst nightmare. I'm the guy who's gonna whip you lazy blobs into shape.
Alright.
Still, I can't work miracles here. No amount of drilling beats real combat experience. I want you all to go out there, kick some imp tail, and then show me what you learned. I will train that experience into something you can actually use. Level you bums up. But don't go trying to hog all the glory. A squad's a team, and we got no need for stars. You will train as a class and level up by class. Scout level 2, scout level 3. You get it?
Yep, I get it.
When the scouts level up, that means each and every one of them goes up that level. You hear me, maggots? Any of you think he's better than the rest of the team? Go home now! Alright. Now I'll show you lowlights how this whole thing actually works. It ain't complicated. First you go out there and fight. Then divvy up that experience here. Once the experience you cram into a soldier class clears a set amount, it'll level up. Picking which class to level up and when is your job as the squad leader. Now give it a go.
Alright, well, let's see.
Train all you want. I've got all day.
So we can increase scout, which we actually have. We got shock trooper, which we have. We don't have an engineer or sniper. We have lancer. So, right now, let's level up Scout, and Shock Trooper. So, the info just tells us what we actually have. And then let's just upgrade the Lancer since we have so much XP right now. And then let's
You're better than this. Push
those use
limits.
Those. To level them up.
Good work, maggots. You're one level closer to human. Looks like that session beat a new potential out of the Lancers.
Now that's a lot of XP, let's just upgrade Scout one more time. And then just leave it at that for now.
Bite the bullet! No pain, no gain!
then...
Good work, maggots! You're one level closer to...
Let's see what else we got.
Got it? That's how training by class works. Now get out there and rack up some experience. Oh, and there's one more thing to add. Sometimes leveling up a unit class will unlock a hidden potential in them. You can think of potentials as the natural abilities your soldiers have inside them. Those abilities will form a big part of your strength in the field, so keep them in mind. Other times, leveling up a class will earn you clearance for a new order. Here, as long as we're talking about it, I'll teach you a classic. A real golden oldie.
Evade boost. This order raises one ally's evasion skill. Alright.
Orders are special commands you can give out as the squad leader. They can save your tail. It doesn't take a genius to see that leveling up your soldiers is the best way to beef up your squad. The soldiers will get stronger. And you just might unlock new potentials and orders. All that just from me working you sorry bums into the dirt. I just hope you maggots are ready for a real workout the next time I see you here.
Well, we couldn't upgrade the tank, but we did manage to upgrade Scout a few times than everybody else. But let's see, upgrade the equipment, let's see what equipment we can actually upgrade here.
Welcome to R&D, man. What can I do you for? Wait, I know that insignia. You're Lieutenant Gunther, aren't you? I knew it! Man, I've heard about you! That evacuation at Brule was just... wow! A tiny life in the middle of all that slaughter? Man! Oh, Lieutenant, you're good people. You get all my respect and then some, bro.
What's going on, Leon? I could hear you from clear across the hangar.
Oh, Casey, check it out! It's Lieutenant Gunther! He's the man, man!
Sorry about him, Lieutenant. He's like this all the time, I'm afraid. But where are my manners? I'm Kreese Cherney. I'm training here as a mechanic.
Oh, and I'm Leon Schmidt. But just call me Leon, bro. I'm your boy.
So, Lieutenant Gunther, what brings you down to R&D today? We do work here on weapons development. Making upgraded weapons and equipment.
And that includes rifles and machine guns. We can even soup up your tank. Of course, research expenses aren't cheap.
With rifles and other firearms, we'll mass produce new models as they're developed. You won't have to worry about making enough for your squad. We'll outfit them.
For tanks, you can upgrade the baseline performance of the body itself, or develop optional parts that you can add on to tweak out its specs.
Right. You can choose which optional parts you want in the tank equipment section. Come in anytime and make adjustments based on the needs of the operation at hand.
Alright, well, now we got outfitting tank development. While our work on tanks happens in the form of body enhancements, treads, and weak points improvements, and tack support. Body enhancements mostly reinforce the gun barrel and body armor and to improve the base stats. Tanks will automatically be given the best body type you have developed. Your device, whether to favor attack or defense, and altering body types gives you a tank a different outward appearance. Improvements to the treads and weak points and attack support take the form of parts that can be added to the tank's to enhance their abilities, each part has a set in blocks. You'll decide how to fill the 4x3 block storage capacity in the Iswill? That's how you pronounce that, right? Pick the optional parts that best fit your own personal combat style. Alright. Well, we got development weapons, which we got rifles. Well, let's see, hand grenades, what do we got? Well, we don't have anything here. Do we have anything in rifles? Accuracy boost? I mean, yes, why not? We got the money for the accuracy boost, let's make it.
Here you go, bro. All done.
We got the cash, let's make sure that we can actually hit the target. Eh, it's only 500 to get the extra firepower. May as well get the firepower too.
All set for you, bro. It's done.
So like later on, I might do some of these upgrades off camera. We'll just have to wait and see. Otherwise, we got lances. We got firepower. Increase this by 5 and 50 on armored. Cost about 700. We'll wait on that. Otherwise, uniforms. We got anything here? I mean, 500 for an extra one defense. That one extra defense might be a game difference from a game over or not. So, let's get the one extra defense. What are blast suits? Just anti-blast. Don't know if we have any of those. Otherwise, our tank body enhancements. What we got? Just plus 200 range or 300 defense, which is really expensive. Trade HP and then crit defense. Otherwise, attack support. What we got in here? Accuracy by 5. We might just grab that accuracy. But let's just see what else we got in the outfit of the tank. So, if we change parts, we don't have anything else in change parts. Alright.
Well, sir, was that helpful?
Oops, I went too far.
Working here around the clock to make possible tomorrow what's out of reach today. Come again a little later. We'll do our best to have something useful for you by then. Yeah, you better come back soon, bro. I am all fired up to work on stuff for you.
Yeah, I'm gonna be back, like, in the next... like, now, because I didn't get any tank parts and just backed off.
Bro, I'm stoked you're here, man. What can I do you for?
We want tank weapons. We want the tank weapons. Right now, let's just take the extra defense on the tank.
It's done. This one's perfect, bro.
Because I don't know what our actual kind of things we're going to be going up against right now. And then let's just get an extra won't get it on that. Oh, I can do that. Let's definitely get plus 5 accuracy for right now.
Here you go, bro.
And we got bulletproof visor, yeah. So I guess this is the 4x3 that they were talking about. That some things will actually need to be placed in there. So, another thing to kind of figure out. Otherwise, could get the extra range, but right now, I'm just gonna save just in case we get something else. So, let's just exit the facility.
Come back again soon, bro. I mean it, man.
continue on because this choosing which members do I have an option right now, really? Let's just check quickly. Pretty sure we don't have much of an option.
It's good to see you doing the rounds. Welcome. This is the command room. Use it to structure your squad. You will have access to both drafted and volunteer recruits. Now that I think of it, Squad 7 is still short on soldiers, isn't it? I'll explain how this works. This is the master list. The recruits have all been assigned classes based on their talents. I should probably touch on the 5 classes, just so we're clear. First off, you have the scouts. Just like the name suggests, they'll be your eyes. Their best asset is their mobility. They can go out, collect intel, then make it back safely.
Alright.
That, and a keen eye for enemies. A good scout can spot a man in tall grass from 100 yards. That comes at the price of firepower. Their job is spotting enemies, not taking them out. Next up, the shock trooper. They're the ones to break through enemy lines and clean up. They offer excellent offense and defense. As far as combat goes, they're as good as it gets. While they lack any specialized techniques, they also don't have any obvious shortcomings. Think of them as the least finicky unit in your squad, Lieutenant. After them, we have lancers, then anti-tank units. They're critical when facing armored targets.
Okay, so the lancers are that.
Pretty self-explanatory. In most cases, they're the only way to stop a tank. They're also well shielded from explosives, which conveniently includes tank mortars. Sadly, they're slow and weak to gunfire. Their limited ammo could also be called a drawback. Changing gears, we have the engineers. They handle supplies and perform combat support. They can restock other units' ammunition, treat the wounded, even repair tanks on site. They can place sandbags for cover, disarm mines, repair towers, you name it.
Okay, so we're definitely going to want one of those eventually.
Their actual combat skills are very low. Think of them as combat facilitators. Lastly, we have the snipers. They can shoot down targets from a considerable distance. You won't find better soldiers for marksmanship and range. They can hit targets I can barely see. Sniping rifles also come with scopes that work to augment a sniper's natural eyesight. Drawbacks include low mobility and defense. If the enemy gets them alone, they're done for. That should cover the basics. Go ahead and put a squad together now. There's room for 20, and you can swap units at any time.
Alright, well, we can get our own squad now. We got 17. So we got another scouts here. So we want to be looking at who they like. And then I guess a little bit of their extra things here. So paved roads feel strange and cold, leading to discomfort and lower defense. And then pure hatred for the Empire yields a boost in accuracy. But if we look at who they like, we don't have any of those in our team right now. And I don't know if we can actually end up removing some of them or not later on. But right now... Oh yeah, we can. So we can remove them, but they won't allow us to remove them right now. But the ones that they give us, probably can't remove. Is there a way to make it... Alright, we got a few snipers here. Two snipers, two mechanics here, which I would like to get in. Heavy pollen allergies means that a steady drain from HP when staying too much plant life. Having allies nearby is a distraction that causes a drop of invasion ability. Their keen sight is by the darkness night, laying them fire with enhanced accuracy. Okay. Why is it scrolling like that? I'm gonna use this. Anyways, we got this guy, which does have a little bit more HP than. Why do you have to do that game? A little bit more HP plus likes a few people. Stand on loose stand sharpness awareness leading to improved evasion. Okay, so that must have been what the ducking underneath the sandbags earlier is, evasion. Confidence that can be best by any sniper grants a boost in attacking abilities. Even just being around somebody makes them nauseous, leading in decrease in defense. Well, I don't even have this person on my team right now. So as long as I don't get this person, I may as well just add him.
My name is Cesare Regard, and I'll handle things my own way, thank you.
So then we just have a sniper. And then would like to get a engineer. Let's see. What I'll do is I'll just pick the one here right now. I'm just picking an engineer now, and then later on off camera I'll pick one and fit a squad up together. Let's see. Metalhead, the smell of iron clears the head, leading to a boost of in attack power. Okay. Loneliness soon sets in when no allies are nearby, leading to decreased evasion. Okay, well, right now, we'll just add him.
My name's Carl Lanzett, sir. It's a pleasure to join you.
And that'll be for now. I'll toss in one more. I don't know how many we can actually take in on into battle. So, oh, we just gotta fill it. Okay. So right now we'll just toss in a few random people. We won't look at the.
Please call me Wavy. From today onward, we fight together.
We won't really worry about who we put in, and I will just kind of sort it all out later. If I see some that like match up here. That likes and stuff.
Looks like I'll be joining you in squad 7.
And other traits that I recognize here from the ones I've quickly read over, I will just add them in and go on from there, kind of idea. Well, let's see. Well, let's add him in.
Paige Salinger, reporting for duty, sir.
Let's get a few other Lancers in here.
Jan Walker, I'll fight with everything I've got.
Let's see. We'll just put in another mechanic.
I'm Ramsey Clement.
And then let's put in a few more scouts.
I'm Nochi Wordsworth. Hi.
I'm Frisia York, handsome. I know you'll take real good care of me.
I mean, Scout Killer probably is just a self-explanatory. Confidence that they can beat any scout, yeah. Worries about. Okay, so. Dirt stain, so probably doesn't like going to talk grass. Otherwise, they got good accuracy. May as well.
Hi, I'm Alex Raymond. I look forward to serving with you, Welkin.
And. Let's add him.
Name's Kobe Caird, boyo. Looks to me like we're gonna see a lot of each other.
Who else we got? We got six more slots. It's like they just want me to add everybody.
My name's Hector Calvi, sir. I'm at your service from today on.
Let's see. Rosie is in my squad already, so may as well.
Sherry Steinen, like with a J. It's silent, but I'm not.
And let's see. We'll add her.
I'm Edie Nelson. Perhaps you've heard of me. I'm sure we'll get along swimmingly.
But something like this, I'll definitely be doing off camera and putting together a good team.
Hi there. I'm Yoko Martens. I'm sure we'll get along.
That will kind of work together, kind of idea. But like I said, I don't know exactly how many we'll actually be able to add into combat. Helps so sand and grassy field helps relax, increasing their defense. Gives them a boost in cozy places like trenches. Seems common, gives them a boost in attack power. Okay, well, just like boost attack power everywhere. Let's add her. Let's add her. Otherwise, we'll just add one more Lancer.
The name's Walter Nash, buddy. Pleasure to be working with you.
Now we can actually leave this menu.
Well, feel like you've struck a balance? Come back anytime you'd like. As time passes, we'll have more recruits to choose from, so keep an eye on that list. Oh, and all the recruits go through training together, so they're all ready for combat. They'll be at the same level as the rest of the team you've taken into the field. You can swap out members without the worry of losing the benefit of their experience. Trust in your own judgment and pick a team you know you can work well with. That should be enough to get you started. You can figure out the rest as you go.
Alright, well that gives us a little bit more of a strategy kind of angle of things.
Wow, squad leader's a lot of responsibility.
come to think of it, Valdio's heading up Squad 1, isn't he? I wonder if he's off sorting through this stuff now, too. I'd better get a move on.
Alright, I feel like that's enough scrolling through this stuff, so just go back to the book mode and get through some of the cutscenes. And check out, see what, if we can even use some of our things. About headquarters, you can use experience points, basically what we did. Yeah, we did it. Stopping by before combat or after an operation once you've acquired more resources, it's a good idea. Progress for the game. New content is available after things. Yes, like all things. Let's get back to the story though. After all that picking who we're going to add to the squad. Should've just like spammed A and then just dealt with it later.
Welks.
Hopefully you guys don't mind me going through that though.
There you are. I've been looking for you.
Hey, Ace. How'd your enlistment go? No problems?
I registered as a tank pilot and mechanic. Maintaining and operating the Edelweiss will be my responsibility from now on. I think it's nice that we'll all be on the same squad together. I think so too.
So what are you up to now?
The tank's hangar space is just through here. I was just carrying some Ragnite fuel back. It's used to power the tank, and also for the turret-mounted cannon rounds.
I guess I'm just more used to seeing it in street lamps and medical compounds.
Seems like everything is Ragnite powered these days. That stuff is everywhere. Not enough of it for some people, though. It's the source of a lot of conflict.
They say the Empire's invading only to get at all the Ragnite in Gallian soil.
Oh, that's right. I had something to give you, Welks.
What's this?
Father's flare gun. It was in the barn, but I thought you might have some use for it.
Another hand-me-down.
I gave it a once-over. It might be old, but it's still serviceable.
I didn't mean... I just can't believe I'm a tank operator now. Thank you for this, Ace.
I'll do a spot check on the Edelweiss now, to make sure it's ready to go at any time. Alright, we'll get going for now then. See you later.
Alrighty, so... got a flare gun. That's probably going to come in handy at some point later on. It's, see what this next operation is going to be.
I'll cut to the chase. Here's your mission. The Great Vassal Bridge was just taken by the Empire. It's a key strategic position.
The Great Vassal Bridge?
It's a major drawbridge crossing the canal in Vassal, just outside the capital.
That bridge is a part of the central transit artery, leading into Randgreaves. Our mission is to take it back.
I don't like how many tanks are there. That's a lot of tanks.
The Empire has been running a blitz, with their shock troops outrunning their defense. Our 3rd Regiment will retake the bridge before defensive reinforcements can arrive.
How quaint! The militia holding a little strategy meeting of its own. Planning on hiding out in here, Verrat?
My apologies, sir. We'll depart soon.
Whatever. They're just country mice. It's not like they'll be much help.
More help, perhaps, than your army unit that couldn't hold the bridge in the first place.
Hey!
Regardless, Vassal remains a critical position. We'll reclaim it immediately.
Well, all good. See that you do.
Who is that? General Damon, commander of the Central Forces.
Central Forces? That's the army branch the militia was folded into, right?
That's right. They say the general's an aristocrat. He looks down on the common militia.
That doesn't make any sense.
Right. Now that the war's begun, we all need to band together and fight to keep Gallia safe. Who cares at this point whether you're in the army or the militia? It's ridiculous.
Gentlemen, let's return to the mission. We'll begin by taking back the western bank to gain a foothold for reclaiming the bridge. Lieutenant Gunther, I'm assigning Squad 7 to this mission. It's your first maneuver, so be smart.
Yes, Captain.
The other squads are on patrol. Stay sharp and be ready to help take back the bridge. I'm counting on all of you out there. Now move out.
Alright, well, we got Operation Take Back the Bridge, and now we got skirmishes. Unlike those within the main storyline, the battle found underneath the skirmishes tab can be played any number of times. Perfect for messing experience and research fees. Try them too if you feel feeling underpowered. Press the Y button to open the menu, then choose skirmishes tab. Alright, new skirmishes added as you progress through the main plot, and the difficulty of each skirmish can be set freely, alright? Just be careful though, not a plot battle, soldiers lost during skirmishes still can die. Alrighty, so we got another operation here. I've been recording a while on this one, thinking with how long the operations can take. I'm going to end it here, so then the episode doesn't go on for like an hour. Well, for however long this operation takes me. So I'm going to leave it here. I'm excited to do this operation. So please like, subscribe, so then you can see this operation. Comment down below if you would like me to do a separate video on me just putting together a squad and making it so that my class squad is all together. Otherwise, comment down below if there's anything that I should improve on or anything that I'm not understanding that you may know. So thank you for your support there. And until next time.